Welcome. I'm just getting started, and it doesn't really get fully dark for another 20-something minutes. SkyTool says totally dark from 8:49, and it's only 8:22, so it's 27 minutes is full darkness. Okay, let me fill in some of the parameters. Five-second exposure. Gain is 40. Where's the gamma? 1.6. 1.60. Sharpness is at, well, I gotta put the cooling, the cooler is on. Okay, cooler's on. Sharpness is, let me go to 50%. Hi, Graham. Hopefully you can hear me. What other parameters do I have to put up? Presets, miscellaneous, sharpness, cooling. Okay. Not a problem. More options the better in these days of self-isolation and quarantining. I think I've clipped that way too much. Conversion gain dB2. Okay. So digital binning 2, high conversion gain. Cooling, conversion gain. Hey, Jeff. Do I have a 5-second dark applied? Digital binning 2. To zoom in on the nucleus right now, because it looks like you can see like two pieces in. You can see like there's like a break right through here. Yeah, there's a star. get some fainter stars. Well, there's a star here, and there's another star back here. I don't know if that's what you were talking about. No idea why. In real-time mode, and why does it keep changing time on the charts? The charts are not staying current. Those three stars are what, 11-1, 12-3, top. That's the relative magnitudes of those three bright stars. Say hi, Bob, Don, and guests. That's a ridiculous man. What's your sugar now? Unbelievable. Yeah. Okay. Love you. Bye-bye. If I could try a longer exposure. come on. It's stuck. Okay, let's try 8 second loop. Another color, a white balance. Okay, let me start aligning now. Okay, so now we're at 8 seconds. Hey, Rusty. All right, where's my histogram? It's a little breezy out here tonight. It's when I tried the Batinoff mask earlier, it was bouncing all over creation. Snow. God. Well, it's 75 degrees right now in the observatory. She's having all kinds of issues tonight with her blood sugars. That's 125. Jim, it sure looks like the nucleus is really elongated. And when I zoomed in before, it looked like there was kind of a break right in between here, the nucleus and everything else. There's a little gap. Stop capturing. Okay, let me go back to auto capture. That's a 400% zoom. Yeah, if you're seeing a gap, it's a big gap. And I would have to say that the main nucleus is like right there. It's not a bad looking comet. Well, in 10 minutes it's supposed to be the end of astronomical twilight. I'd have to say the comet does look pretty good. I'm going to stop this and I'm going to try a little bit longer exposure. Stop the live stacking. I'm going to go to 10 seconds. Stop. Loop at 10 seconds. And let me apply a 10-second dark. Forty gain 10 seconds open. Enable. Okay, 10-second. Oh, I didn't have a dark applied before. Oops. Is it going up at all? Okay. Crazy. Oh well. Yeah. And time for another Easter egg. No. Oh, okay. All sugar. Yeah. Okay. I'll keep an eye on you. Okay, love you. Okay. Bye-bye. Zoom them a little bit more, Jeff. What are you talking about? I Let's see, I hope that won't screw up anything. Oh yeah, cool. Interesting. That's the full frame without vignetting. Go a little bit wider, but what I didn't put down, I have two focal reducers. I have the Ritchie Cretion focal reducer attached to a T to 2-inch adapter, and then the Universe focal reducer, and then the camera. So I got two focal reducers close coupled. And let me change this, because this is now 10 seconds. Looks rather nice. Maybe I'll put them on the bottom, let's see. Hopefully that makes sense to somebody. So it's the camera, the Universe focal reducer, a T to 2-inch adapter, and then the Ritchie Cretion focal reducer. Should we try with a longer exposure, or you think 10 is it? That's too long. 15 seconds is too much. Okay, stop. How about 12? So that's 12. And start. So let's see what happens with 12 seconds. I think that 12 seconds is too much. Yeah, think 10 was probably the best. Okay. Let's go to another target. Stop the stack. Okay. And
the telescope is slewing. Slew complete.
Okay. Let me go back down to 10 seconds, because I think 12 may be too much. 10 seconds. Let's see where the histogram is. That's probably the issue. Yep, the histogram. Go. 31.48. Let's see what happens with. Okay. Center and sink on it. This looks pretty good tonight.
Telescope position synchronized.
After this, we're going to go to Comet Pan-STARR. It's a pretty galaxy. Let's enable the live stacking now. Okay. After this and the next comet, I think we're going to be looking at galaxies the rest of the night. Anybody new join the room? Nope, not yet. Okay. Yeah, Don, there was hope for it being naked eye, super bright, but only time will tell if that's going to happen. I think the way it's falling apart now, that's not going to occur. Started at no filters. Yeah, I just boosted the sharpness from 50% to 100%. And it definitely brought out some more detail in the core. This view, we flip it. Supposed to be a Leda galaxy. It's just around the Gain name, but I don't. Triangle of stars. No, it must be right out the field of view.
Telescope position synchronized.
There's Pan Star over there. Sugar. No data. Yeah, now I have no data. What's going on? Okay. I think I should have worn long pants. It's starting to get cool out here. Yeah, oh yeah, I will. Okay. Talk to you later. Love you. Bye-bye. Off to Comet Pan-STAR. Okay, let's see. Stop the live stacking. Default histogram. Okay.
The telescope is slewing.
Let me see where it is.
Slew complete.
Let me raise the pier up and get above the walls. Okay. I'll turn the blue lights off. The blue light special at Kmart. Okay. Oh, that's the comet right next to that star. Oh, good. Got lucky. Let me go to a shorter exposure. I want to get the comet over to the center. Too much. God, let me go back down to 12x. Will do. I just want to. I think I have the histogram. Field of Astronomy lost a nice telescope maker today, Rick Spring, Singmaster, who made the star structure telescopes, died. Star Masters, the wooden Dobsonians. He's only like a year or two older than me. I was talking to a friend of mine who lives in Pensacola, who is a good friend of Rick's. His wife Carol called him early this morning to let him know that Rick had passed in his sleep at home. There it is, right in the center. Okay, so now I'm going to synchronize.
Telescope position synchronized.
It's synchronized, and let's go back to a longer exposure. Let's try something, maybe start at 5 seconds and see what happens. Go a little bit longer, maybe go back to maybe 10. Or 8. I'm going to loop at 8. So this is a race. And this is. And stars. Night, Graham. Glad you could stop by. And this is 8 seconds. 8 seconds. Okay, so let's bring this histogram over. Do a white balance. .3756. Let's see what happens. Slight change, that's all. Okay. And now let's average stack. According to Sky Tools, right now it is magnitude 8.4. That star to its right is 6.6 magnitude. Looking for stars that I can match up. That. Row of stars right there. There's supposed to be an MCG galaxy in there, but I don't see it. This is ridiculous. There was another galaxy nearby this one. Let's see.
Telescope position synchronized.
That's the faint spiral I wanted to look at the other night. I don't know how often Greg updates his magnitudes in his comets. This is a faint face on. I tried to do the other night, but the clouds killed me. I'm going to go to it next. So I'm going to disengage the stack and go to the default histograms and go to this galaxy.
The telescope is slewing.
It's not far.
Slew complete.
I see 342. I see 342. I see it, and it's about as fantastic as it was the other night. facetious. There's a row of stars here. And the galaxy is right here. So let's move. Try to move everything over. Get the galaxy core in the center. This galaxy, let's see, what does it say about it? It says its magnitude is 9.6, 8.1 million light years from Earth, but I think it has a real low surface brightness. Yeah, I just got into this galaxy the other night, and then the clouds wiped everything out. Okay, let's see. That's getting closer. I see 3, 4, 2. And here, let me get some information on it.
On this night, I see 340.
Oh, quiet. There's the information. Yeah, surface brightness is 24.2 magnitudes per square arc second. Very low. 8.1 million light years from Earth and 47,000 light years across. So let's see if I can do some... turned on phone off. That's ridiculous. Her sugars are really been whacked all day. Let me try 10 seconds. Loop. And then let me start stacking. At least with this new monitor she has, I can see her sugars while she sees them. That's a pretty large galaxy. Wow. I don't know if it's me, but I think it goes all the way out to here. already have the gamma pretty high. Any suggestions on adjusting, like, contrast higher, lower? There's a lot of structure in that galaxy, too. I see. See, that wasn't on my list of what I wanted to look for, but it's a nice galaxy. Just bump the okay. I just changed the gamma to 1.7. See if that will help darken it up a little. I mean, you go to 100%, the galaxy fills the field. It's 75. Yeah, it is, Rusty. I'm looking at the... See if I can bring this DSS image over. It's kind of turned a little bit, but you can see the bar of stars in the galaxy. The circle is the extent that Greg Kinklaw says the galaxy has. That is nice. It really is. What the heck? Let's see. Capture. Stop capture. Do a snapshot. Capture. Auto capture. Let's see if we can tweak this, see if I can pull anything out of this. That is nice looking. Wow. To show this to Rock in the morning. Thanks, Jeff and Jim. Yeah, this is nice. Oh, let's see. What's next on my hit parade? I was looking at it's called Astronomical League 2 in the View. 3521. Let's see where 3521 is. No filters. 35:21. Where did it go? Oh, come on. NGC 3521. Search.
On this night, NGC 3521 is best visible between 2032 and 110. With the optimum view at 2235. Look for it in Leo.
Oh, means meridian flip. Oh, lordy, lordy. Yep, southeast. Find something I'm gonna have to do a sync. I'm gonna go to Regulus slew to
the telescope is slewing
meridian flip.
Slow complete.
Batteries are dead in my finder scope. Batteries are dead in my radical eyepiece. Unbelievable. unbelievable. Can't even find Regulus in a finder scope.
Stop in the stack. What is going on? My camera froze up again, so now I gotta stop the camera. Well, this is M95, so let me. M95, I hope. Let me center it on and then I'm going to go to the real galaxy I wanted to go to.
Telescope position synchronized.
Okay, let's try again. What's my exposure? I'm at 10 seconds. Okay, so let's just start stacking. See what that does to it. Okay, and I gotta apply a dark E key. Import a 10-second dark. 40 gain, 10 seconds, open, import. Okay, so that's done. Yeah, Jim, I hung in. Hi, Bernie. Oh. So now I gotta find the right batteries for the finder scope. This was not my intended target. My next target was going to be a galaxy ...3521. before and go, let me think.
Telescope position synchronized.
That's the next galaxy I'm looking for. Okay. I haven't heard from Jim O'Connor in a while. Is he doing okay? I think we're planning on canceling all of our reservations prior to the Grand Canyon. And if the Grand Canyon Star Party is a go, we'll just head right to the Grand Canyon and avoid going to Yellowstone and all the points further north. It'll allow us to leave near the end of May instead of early May, if everything starts winding down. Yeah, I heard it's still a go, but right now everything's shut down at the Grand Canyon except for a full hookup trailer village. Emailing with Sarah Bercher at Lowell. I really want to get to see Godo. They're shut down. They're hoping to reopen by Memorial Day weekend. So if they do, if we do have the Grand Canyon Star Party, we'll go to that, then we'll go to Lowell afterwards. And then we'll head back to Louisiana and visit Bob on the way back. Yeah, N95's not looking bad. Forgot. Snapshot. Go back to live. Options, preferences, auto capture. 30 seconds, capture 1,000 of them. Apply, okay. Capture, auto capture, okay. Okay, so let's see what happens with this snapshot. Process range. Nice. So now let me go to the galaxy I wanted to go to originally, NGC 3521. Kind of reminded me a little bit of the M63, the Sunflower. NGC 3521. Thanks, Jim. Yeah, it does look nice. Okay, so now we're gonna go stop the live stacking, default histogram, and go to this galaxy. SLU 2 in center.
The telescope is SLUing. SLU complete.
I think the galaxy's there with the bright star next to it. Yeah, there it is. Okay. Well, that's the galaxy I was looking for. Let me go to a little bit shorter exposure. Let's see if I can get the core to the center. Too much. There it is. Okay, now let's sync on that.
Telescope position synchronized.
Okay, now let's go back to longer exposure. It looked like 10 was too much. Maybe I'll go to 7. See what happens. It's like the Sunflower, but a little bit more tilted. Gotta try a little bit less sharpness. 50% sharpness, let's see what happens. Seeing some knots in the spiral arms. if we can bring the this is the DSS image imported into SkyTools. Let's see if I can pick up some of those Leda galaxies that are nearby. There's the leaders. I see them now. Got it started at 50%, and now I'm gonna increase the sharpness to 100 and see what it does in the stack. One of the galaxies is here. One galaxy there. This is LEDA 135. That's a weird name. That's never heard of this catalog before. Z10-72. I think it's magnitude 16.2. Interesting. Not bad for 7 seconds. Let's see what happens if I stop and increase it to 10 and continue the loop. Started at 7 seconds and now I'm at 10 seconds. Right next to this is an Abel galaxy cluster with tons of little dots in the field of view. I'm going to go to that one next. Let me clean up some of the stuff in this image. Pretty nice. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to stop the capture. Grab a snapshot, go back to auto capture, and let's see if I can tweak this. Oh, look at this outer arms detail. Very, very nice. Okay, let's move over to this Abel Galaxy cluster, which is right next door.
Telescope position synchronized.
This Abel Galaxy cluster.
The telescope is slewing.
Like I said, it's not far.
Slew complete.
And we're going to ACO 1139. Now let me go and stop the default histogram, stop the stack. Okay. need more than my 10 seconds now. Yeah. Good night, Jeff. Bunch of faint fuzzies in there as far as which is which. I think those are three galaxies right above the sea in camera at the bottom. Let me get a DSS image downloaded. Yes, I got that. That was the first thing I looked at, Bernie. I didn't grab a capture. I'm recording a video. I'm almost 2 hours into a video. But you could actually see the parts of the nucleus where it had broken apart. Those three little dots right above the sea in camera, that's this row of galaxies right here. Leda, UGC. And then, galaxies, that dot there. There is stuff everywhere. Well, I'm going to go to something that's a little bit more, $34.95. Oh, let me get to that list. That list was called Astronomical League 2 in the View. Okay. My next target would be $34.95. up. Okay, let's do a search. NGC 3495.
On this night, NGC 3495 is best visible between 2044 and 2421. The telescope is slewing.
I knew it wasn't far away.
Slew complete.
There it is. Bingo. Exposure time on my head. I'm at 10 second exposure, so let me erase that. 10, 10, blue, 10. And this is 10GC. 3495. Oops, something just glitched. Let's do a little live stacking. That little fuzz above it is another Z galaxy, Z3887. Its magnitude is 15.9, and right above it is Alita that is 17.2. That little LEDA 213 213 771. See, where's my sharpness right now? It's at 100. I see a little bit of structure in the main galaxy. Some structure on the top edge closest to the other galaxies. just reduced the sharpness down to 50. It was at 100, so I reduced it to 50. Bright start, the field of view, you can actually see a little bit of detail in that galaxy. Hi Jim, glad you could stop by. Let's see. I can tweak anything about out of this thing. What's the next thing on my list? Is it 5509?
Telescope position synchronized.
What?
Telescope position synchronized.
NGC 5509. Search.
On this night, NGC 5509 is best visible between 2108 and 545. The telescope is slewing.
NGC 4039. Excuse me. And this is, let me sync on it.
Telescope position synchronized.
And let me go to a longer exposure. Now that I'm in the right spot, let me try 10, see if it'll work with 10. Nope, 10's not gonna work. How about 7? Start some stacking. And this is 7 seconds. And what's the... Where's my sharpness? Sharpness is at 50%. I don't know if you're seeing what I'm seeing, but I'm seeing this one tail arching all the way over there. The other tail is not quite as pronounced. It's definitely there. So I didn't get the antenna.
The telescope is slewing.
do one more target for tonight, and I'm going to call it quits.
Slow complete.
Is that down in the... Do another white balance, getting all of the... light pollution from down in slot L. Maybe a little bit shorter exposure too. Go to 5 seconds. This is 5 seconds. Five. Let's do an average stack. And this is going to be it for tonight for me. I got up real early. So let me put the title in, so M104. Bernie, Bob, and guests, I'm calling it quits for tonight. If it's clear tomorrow night, I'll try to do another broadcast. But for now, y'all stay safe, and I'll see you the next time around. Good night.